Welcome to the video lesson, students. Dear students, in paper 1 for 10th class students, in paper 1, the polynomials covers the major portion. So most of the students will lose their 10 mark rank or lose in mathematics because of 2 marks questions. So today I'll discuss all type of 2 marks questions under this polynomials and quadratic equation category. See, if we take different types of questions under 2 marks question category, under quadratic equations and polynomial. When you take a quadratic polynomial, look at here. I have taken x square plus 3x minus 4. So the same quadratic polynomial may be asked, the different types of questions may be asked. Here I have displayed 10 types of different types of questions under 2 marks category. See how they may be asked. I have taken single quadratic polynomial, that is x square plus 3x minus 4. See, first one, this is a direct question, factorize the quadratic polynomial. The second question, verify whether minus 4 and 1 are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. The third question, if the quadratic polynomial is given, you have to find out the nature of roots, whether they are real, not real, or equal. The fourth question, find the quadratic polynomial if the roots are given, that is the zeros are given. Fifth question, if the sum and the product of the roots of the quadratic polynomials are given, find the polynomial. That is, sum and product is given, you have to find the polynomial. The sixth question, if the polynomial is given and one unknown value is given, here, look at here, k is an unknown value. You have to find out the k value, but here hint is given, that is the roots are equal. The seventh question, if minus 4, 1 are the zeros of the polynomial, then you have to find the quadratic polynomial. Eighth question, if p of x is equal to some quadratic polynomial, you have to find out what is p of 2 and p of minus 3. For what value of k, if minus 4 is 0 of the polynomial, so what will be the value of k? If minus 4 is a zero of the polynomial, find the sum and product of the zeros of the polynomial. So the same polynomial I have taken, and there are 10 different types of questions may be asked. Today we will discuss all these questions. When you understand all these questions, you will get mastery over the quadratic polynomial category. So first we'll work out factorization. Factorize x square plus 3x minus 4. So what is the constant here? 4 is the constant, so you have to find out factors for 4. So you have to select two numbers in such a way that when you multiply you should get minus 4, and when you add you should get plus 3. You have to select in such a way. Here the first one, that is 1 into 4 is equal to 4, and 4 into 1 is equal to 4. So these two numbers, that is 1 and 4, will be the factors. That section, 2 into 2 is not possible. So therefore, when you add the numbers, that is plus 4 minus 1, you will get plus 3. And when you multiply plus 4 into minus 1, you will get minus 4. So the selected factors are, one is plus 4 and another one is minus 1. So let us solve the problem now. So there are three terms in this quadratic polynomial. See, in the middle term, you have to remove this middle term. In place of that middle term, you may write like plus 4x minus 1x. That is plus 4 and minus 1, you'll get plus 3, like this, plus 3. So the x is there, so I have kept x here in both two terms. So the second step is very important. So now you group the two terms. and what is common here in these two terms, x is common, you take out x. So what remains in the bracket, that is x plus 4. Again, x plus 4, you'll get the third term coefficient will come and place in here. Now you take x plus 4 as a common. When x plus 4 is taken out, what is there inside? That is x minus 1. So x plus 4 is equal to 0, x minus 1 is equal to 0. So the zeros are, when you take plus 4 to the other side and minus 1 to the other side, you will get the zeros for the quadratic polynomial are minus 4 and 1. Second question. What is the second question now? Verify whether minus 4 and 1 are the zeros of the polynomial. So how can you say that these two numbers are the zeros for the polynomial? Like, see here. So here, in place of x, when you substitute minus 4, see, in place of x, I just kept bracket. First, you have to keep bracket like this. So in place of x, when you substitute minus 4 like this, and simplify, 4 4 16, 3 4 12, minus 4, that is 16. Here when you add, this is 16 plus 16 minus 16 will get cancelled. So you will get 0 as an answer. When you get 0 as an answer, you can say that minus 4 is 0 for the polynomial. And let us verify whether 1 is 0 for the polynomial or not. So in place of x, I've substituted 1. 1 square is 1, 3 into 1 is 3, minus 4. 3 plus 1 is 4, plus 4 minus 4 will get cancelled. You'll get 0 as an answer. So in both the cases, you got 0 as an answer. And definitely you can say that minus 4 and 1 are the zeros for the quadratic polynomial. So this is one model question. Let us move on to the third question. Now you have to find out the nature of roots for this quadratic polynomial. So the nature, how they are. So this is a quadratic polynomial and you have to find out discriminant. Discriminant means delta. Delta is equal to b square minus 4ac is a discriminant. When you find out the value of this, see here, look at here. B square minus 4ac is an indiscriminant. When you get the value of this more than 0, the roots will be real and distinct. When discriminant is equal to 0, the roots will be equal. When discriminant is less than 0, the roots are not real. So for a patient, if he's got fever, so when you check the temperature, if it is 100, you can say the person has got fever. Like that, here, when you find out this discriminant value, if it is more than 1, the roots will be real. If the discriminant value is 0, the roots will be definitely equal. If the discriminant value is less than 0, the roots are not real. So simply, the coefficient of x square is 1, the coefficient of x is 3, the constant is minus 4. C will be minus 4. Let us substitute here. In place of B, we will write 3 square. And AC, in place of A, 1, C minus 4. So this is 9. Minus into minus plus 4 into 4, 16. 16 plus 9, it is 25. 25 number is a positive natural number, which is more than 0. Therefore, you can see that the roots are real and distinct. Let us see one more problem. Under 2 marks question category, find the quadratic polynomial if the zeros are given. See here. So these are the zeros. When you add the zeros, that is sum of the zeros. Let us take the zeros as alpha and beta. The sum of the zeros are minus 4 plus 1, that is equal to minus 3. And the product of the zeros are minus 4 into 1, that is equal to minus 4. So when the sum of the zeros and the product of the zeros are given, there is a formula to find out the quadratic polynomial. The formula is x square minus some other roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. In place of sum, you can write minus 3. In place of product, you can write minus 4. And you will get the quadratic polynomial C. How wonder? We got zeros for this polynomial. In the previous slide, we got as minus 4 and 1. In first problem also, we got the zeros as minus 4 and 1. Now when we know the zeros, so we will get the definitely the same quadratic polynomial. Like we have used the formula and substituted, we got the same quadratic polynomial here. Now the fifth problem, if the sum and the product of the zeros of a quadratic polynomial are given, you have to find the polynomial. In the previous slide, the zeros were given, you need to find out the sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. Now in this problem, the sum and product directly he has given, so there is no need to add directly. In place of alpha plus beta, you can substitute minus 3. In place of alpha beta, you can substitute minus 4 directly. Like, see here. So this is the problem. In place of alpha beta, you can substitute minus 3. In place of alpha plus beta, you can substitute minus 3. In place of alpha beta, you can substitute minus 4. Like this. So we got the problem. See, same quadratic polynomial I have taken. Now look at this question. If p of x is a quadratic polynomial is given, here look at the x quotient, it is somewhat k. K is an unknown value, you have to find out the value of k. And here it is given that the roots are equal. So under which condition the roots will be equal? The delta value, if the delta value is equal to 0, then you can say the roots are equal. See, now write down what is A, B, C. A is x square coefficient, B is x coefficient, and the constant is C. Now you have to find out the discriminant value, the delta value, that is b square minus 4ac. Here is saying that the roots are equal. So the roots are, when the roots are equal, definitely the discriminant will be equal to 0. Now we'll substitute. In place of b, we will write k. And in place of a, 1, c, 9. The value is k square minus 9 fourths 36. When you take 36 to the other side, when you take the square to the other side, it will become root. So 36 root is nothing but 6. So like this, you can find out the value of k. Now the seventh problem, if the minus 4 and 1 are the zeros for the polynomial, and you have to find the polynomial. So this is the formula. To just write the pattern first. You don't write alpha and beta in place of alpha beta. You just keep the bracket like this. It will be more easy. Now simply you write in place. This place is minus 4 place and this place is 1 place. And here one minus 4 place and this is 1 place. Now you substitute like this. Minus 4 plus 1, you'll get minus 3. Minus 3 into minus 3, minus, that is plus, and here minus 4. Now you'll get the quadratic polynomial. So this is when zeros are given, this is the quadratic polynomial. And look at this problem, like this also you may ask. That polynomial is given, you have to find out what is p of 2 and p of minus 3. See, this is a polynomial. Now we'll write the pattern first. In place of x, I have removed the x. Wherever I see x, I have removed it. I just put bracket like this. This will be easy. Most of the students will confuse in the second step only. So carefully write like this. Now you substitute p 2 like this 2. In place of wherever you see bracket, empty place, you put 2 like this. Now 2 2's, it is 4. 3 2's, 6. Plus 4. 4 plus 4, it is 8. 8 minus 6, it is 2. Now we'll find out for p of minus 3. The same procedure. Here, minus 3 in place of bracket. Every time you have to substitute minus 3 like this. 3, 3 is 9. 3, 3 is 9. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 4, it is 22. So, like this. And look at this problem. Find the value of k if minus 4 is 0 of the polynomial. It is given that minus 4 is a 0 of this polynomial. So definitely when you take minus 4, p of minus 4, p of minus 4 is a 0. So let us write the polynomial first. And he is given minus 4 is 0. So p of, let us write the pattern first. So wherever we see x, wherever I see x, I just kept bracket. I didn't write x. I just kept bracket. Now we'll write what is p of minus 4. See, in place of bracket, I have substituted minus 4. So minus 4 is 0. Therefore, compulsory p of minus 4 will be 0. So this is 0. Here, 4, 4 is 16. Minus into minus, it is plus 4. And when you remove this bracket, see here, when you remove this bracket, the plus will become minus. So here, nothing is there, plus into minus, it is minus, and it is minus. So here you will get 20 minus 2, it is 18. Yes, 18 minus 2k. When you take 2k to the other side, 18 is equal to 2k, and the k value is 18 by 2, it is 9. Now the 10th problem, find the sum and product of the zeros for this polynomial. So the polynomial is given, you have to find out what is the sum and the product. The formula, this is a polynomial and a value is 1, b value is 3 and c value is minus 4. The sum of the zeros will be minus b by a. This is a formula, minus b by a. And the sum of the zeros, that is minus b by a, in place of b, you write 3. So the sum of the zeros is minus 3. And the product of the zeros will be c by a. This is the formula. In place of c, you substitute minus 4. Minus 4 by 1. You'll get minus 4. So sum of the zeros are minus 3. Product of the zeros are minus 4. Look here, the quadratic polynomial is same. So one, when you take one quadratic polynomial, how many different types they may ask under 2 marks question category. If I miss any questions in this session, I'll discuss the same questions in the next session. If any questions were repeated, you just learn. And if any questions were missed, I'll discuss in the next session. Okay, thank you.